Hi, welcome. My name is Debbie Pike. I'm Assistant Dean for Undergraduate Programs here at the Chaffetz School of Business at St. Louis University, and I'm also a member of the accounting faculty. I wish we were able to meet in person, and I sure hope that I get the chance to meet with you soon, sometime in the future. I'm going to share with you today some of the many reasons why I hope that being a business billiken may be the right choice for you. We are proud to be a business school that is a part of a Jesuit university. We embrace the academic rigor that comes along with the Jesuit approach to education, and we focus on providing experiential opportunities for our students to apply the knowledge that they gain in the classroom. But just as importantly, we believe in the importance of our graduates being prepared to be ethical leaders, prepared to make a difference. You probably already know that St. Louis University overall is a top 100 school with a number 97 on U.S. News and World Reports, but you may not be aware that our business school is also ranked. We are number 90 in U.S. News and World Reports, and we're going to talk a little bit about some of our individual business degree programs are also individually ranked. I would like to point out that there's an up-and-coming ranking from Poets and Quants that looks at some different attributes, and we have been number 68 on Poets and Quants ranking for 2 years running. You see here on this slide that we are also AACSB accredited for both our business programs and our accounting program. Now, it hasn't been that long that I was in your shoes going from school to school. I was not a college student. That was a long time ago. But I was a parent accompanying my kids on visits, and when I would see that a program was accredited, there was always this alphabet soup up front, just a bunch of letters, and I would check a little box off on my list of schools. Yep, accredited. What I didn't realize until I became a professor was that there's actually a number of different accrediting bodies out there, and that it does make a difference which body is the accreditor. So AACSB is the premier accrediting body for business programs worldwide. Only 5% of business programs are accredited by the AACSB. And if you're looking for programs that are both business and accounting accredited, it's about 2%. And we do fall into that category. Why does that matter? What does it matter who is the accrediting body? Well, it matters because being accredited by the premier body ensures that we are keeping our curriculum up to date. There are strict measures about the appropriateness and the qualifications of our faculty. It's looking at whether or not we have the right career resources to help our students get that leg up when they graduate. Do we have a focus on continuous improvement of our programs? And by being accredited by the AACSB, it ensures that we exceed at all of those things. So let's take a look at some of the individual programs that are also top ranked by U.S. News. We have at number 13, our International Business Program. A number of schools have international business emphasis as a part of their business degree programs, but we have an actual Bachelor of Science in International Business here at SLU, and as you can see, it's very highly ranked. Entrepreneurship is another highly ranked program with a long history here at St. Louis University. We are blessed with being right in the middle between a couple of innovation districts, and St. Louis is an up-and-coming, growing area for business innovation. And it's not just U.S. News and World Report that thinks that we are strong in entrepreneurship. Both the Princeton Review and Entrepreneur Magazine agree that our program is a top 50 program. Finally, finance comes in at number 49. Again, we're very proud of our individual programs that have received this recognition from U.S. News and World Report. I hope I've given you something to think about in regards to our strength of our programs and how appealing they might be for you. But I do appreciate that a family is making an investment when a student comes to SLU. So I think it's important to recognize whether or not you're getting a good value for your money. So it's gratifying that SLU is highly recognized as a top educational value. And that recognition comes from a wide variety of different sources, from U.S. News and World Reports to Princeton Review, Kiplinger's, Barron's. Again, these are all very reputable sources that agree that that investment is worthwhile when you invest in a SLU business education. And before I move away from rankings, I would like to just bring a couple of other things quickly to your attention, and that's in regards to teaching. SLU overall has been rated number 26 in undergraduate teaching from U.S. News and World Reports, and number 47 on the list of U.S. colleges with the best professors by Niche Magazine. I think it's important to think about that undergraduate classroom experience. Are you going to have a powerful experience? You're going to enjoy your time in the classroom. And I think that these rankings show that you'll have a good experience while you're here with us at the Chaffetz School of Business. Again, I truly wish we could be together on campus today so that I could show you around our beautiful Gothic style building and walk around some classrooms with their up-to-date technology. But we're going to go ahead and talk about some of our facilities, take a little bit of a virtual tour, if you will. If we could be together, I would talk a little bit about our classrooms as we're walking through and discuss our 16-to-1 student-faculty ratio, point out that our business classes are all held in our building, that our largest class is capped at 70, which is our Principles of Economics class, but most of our introductory business classes are more like 40 students. As a matter of fact, I'm teaching an Introduction to Financial Accounting class this semester, and I have exactly 40 students in my class. Major classes, so your upper level, once you've decided your major, those tend to be much smaller even than that. We would continue on our tour, and I would take you through our spacious atrium area where our students get together and work on projects, and we'd walk by some of our breakout rooms with their whiteboard walls so that you can study for exams and work on assignments together. And we'd go downstairs to our below ground level and show you our Anheuser-Busch auditorium. It's a full-blown theater-style area where we have guest speakers, initiation ceremonies, recognition ceremonies, things like that, not used for classrooms. And then once we've gone past that, I would take you out towards the Edward Jones Data Analytics Lab. It's just right around the corner from the auditorium. It has a full glass wall where you can see in, and there's a ticker and a number of individual terminals and various screens for playing of videos and presentations, etc. Those terminals that are inside, we have a dozen Bloomberg terminals inside that flexible classroom space. Those Bloomberg terminals are the exact same terminals that are used by Wall Street traders. So as you can imagine, this is a room that is used quite frequently by our finance majors. Those students, as a part of their coursework, will become Bloomberg Market Concept certified, which allows them to have a criteria that's a valuable one for their resumes. But it's not limited to finance students. If you have any interest in learning more about Bloomberg terminals, you are welcome to go during lab hours and take advantage of the online learning modules that are on the terminals for free. And any student in the business school is welcome to also earn that criteria. That classroom space is not just used by our finance students. It's also used by our analytics and enterprise systems students and our economics majors very frequently. Once we finish going through that bright space, we would go across the hall to our behavioral lab where our marketing students have the opportunity to work with their professors to design market research projects, or other students can participate as subjects in market research studies. And then finally, I would like to point out that we have available to us some shared classroom space in the Cortex Innovation District, which is just west of us, where there is a lot of up-and-coming research and venture capitalism starting and really making an impact on the St. Louis metropolitan area. Our business school at St. Louis University benefits from being located in a thriving business community. Not only is St. Louis the headquarters for 15 Fortune 1000 companies, but we are home to some of the nation's largest private companies. We are home to companies that you probably have heard of, like Enterprise Holdings. Enterprise Rent-A-Car will pick you up. They're the number 13 largest private company, and they're located in the St. Louis area. Worldwide Technology, number 30. Edward Jones, number 47. And I could go on and on. It's important that there be a pipeline of growth for our students to have good opportunities. And so we're very excited about the fact that St. Louis has been recognized by Inc. magazine as one of the successes in developing and growing its startup ecosystem. They noted it's a model for other cities and other metro areas to follow. That growth has been in record increase. The top 2,000 private companies grew 38% year over year. We're the number two rising city for startups. All of these business opportunities bring more opportunities for our students to get involved from the ground up and apply their knowledge that they've learned while they're here with us at the Chaffetz School of Business. Our students also benefit from a number of degree-enhancing partnerships. Our finance students benefit from our relationship with the CFA organization. We are a CFA university-affiliated program. So CFA, Chartered Financial Analyst, it is a very demanding exam that, as an accountant, I certainly appreciate tough exams. There are 233 U.S. schools that are CFA, university-affiliated programs. And what that means is that our finance curriculum has been reviewed and deemed closely tied to the professional practice of finance and is well suited to prepare students to sit for that CFA exam. Another one of our partnerships is with the SAP Group. We are an SAP University Alliance Group. This allows our school to provide students in certain courses with hands-on experience with SAP software. SAP is one of the main providers of enterprise resource planning software, the kind of software that's used to run businesses. It allows students to put the classroom theory into practice, and for our IT and data analytics students, they could actually earn a certificate that is valuable to employers. Finally, our marketing students benefit from a partnership with the Nielsen Company. Nielsen is a global measurement and data analytics company that has been around for more than 90 years. They have operations in over 100 countries, covering more than 90% of the world's population. And our partnership with them brings Nielsen's data analytic platforms into several of the marketing department's required and elective courses. The Nielsen Group provides training for our faculty and student and gives them access to the exact same data and tools that's used by the Nielsen firm's own marketing analysts. This partnership gives faculty and students access to current consumer data and an extensive suite of data analytics tools to solve real-world marketing problems. So what will you study if being a business billiken becomes the right thing for you? Well, we offer a well-rounded curriculum based on our Jesuit tradition of a strong arts and sciences foundation. We believe that a good liberal arts foundation is important for a student to develop the right skill sets and talents to succeed in your business courses and, frankly, to succeed as a well-rounded human being when you graduate from SLU altogether. Our curriculum affords both important breadth and depth of knowledge necessary to prepare you for success in today's diverse and highly technical business world. You'd be taking arts and science classes throughout your 4 years, not all up front. Here at SLU, we are a direct entry program, so that means that you can decide upon your very first day with us here at SLU that you are a business student and you are accepted into the business school directly. There's no separate application, etc. You also do not have to take your arts and sciences classes for a couple of years and then transition into the business school. Rather, we have our curriculum set up so that most of our students will take predominantly arts and sciences classes early on, but they'll taper off over your 4 years. And over that same 4 years, you'll gradually pick up and take more and more business common body of knowledge coursework. So it's not a hard stop between your foundation courses and your business courses. We think that that provides a much better balance for our students, gives you the opportunity to make sure that you don't take, perhaps, let's say, if writing is not something that is your strong suit, that you don't take like 5 writing classes all in the same semester or 5 quantitative classes in the same semester if that's not your strength. We want you to be able to have good balance throughout your time here. Speaking of the business common body of knowledge, 45 credit hours of classes would be business common body of knowledge coursework. So your arts and sciences core, back to that for a second, that would be things like science and history and writing and communications, exposures to different ways of thinking and different ways of tackling problems. And then when you transition to the business common body of knowledge, we're looking at different aspects and ways of tackling problems within the more business side of things. So this would be giving you exposure to finance and economics and accounting and management and marketing, etc. My background is from a corporate world, and I would say from my experiences that if you are going to be a part of a team tackling complicated business problems, you're going to find that the other members of that team are folks from different areas across the business, not necessarily all from your area. So it's important that you understand their perspectives, that you understand the strengths that they bring to that team so that together you can tackle those big complicated business problems. Within our business common body of knowledge is also a couple of courses that we find to be big strengths of our program. The first of those courses is our Biz 1000 introduction class. It's a business foundations class. That class is taken during the first semester, and it's to give a basic introduction of business concepts, etc., to students so that you understand early on whether or not business is the right choice for you. Not whether accounting should be your major or marketing, etc., etc., but have you made the right choice with business? We would much rather you come to that commitment, that understanding early on, because if business isn't right for you, it's important for us to help you discern your path here at SLU. So if early on, your first semester, business isn't right, let's help you find what degree program is right for you and get you settled there. Another one of our business common body of knowledge coursework that is interdisciplinary is the Career Foundations course. That course comes second semester sophomore year generally. It's taught by our in-house career resource folks, and it is a 1-credit-hour class that really helps you get set up for your internship search and your full-time job search. Covers things like setting up a LinkedIn profile, resume writing, networking skills, interviewing skills, things like that. And then finally, there's one last 1-credit-hour course in that CBK that covers all of your knowledge. It's a capstone experience in your last semester where you get an opportunity to apply in a simulation all of the cross-discipline knowledge that you have been studying and gathering and accumulating during your time here at SLU. Now, one last thing that I think is important for you is that you're not left on your own to determine your curriculum path. When you do declare your major and all the way along the way, you would have a business school academic advisor who will guide you throughout your 4 years to develop a custom curriculum plan that is designed to help you accomplish your academic goals and will account for any credits that you bring with you. They'll work with you to determine whether or not if you want to study abroad, what are the right classes to leave for that study abroad experience, the timing of when to take certain classes as prerequisites for others. They do a great job in making sure that your custom plan meets all of your needs. One of my colleagues described our students as smart with heart. So to provide sustenance for your intellect, we focus on academics and we offer 10 academic majors, 3 of which are nationally ranked by U.S. News, and 15 academic minors. So just very briefly about our different majors, accounting. We offer both an undergraduate degree in accounting as well as a master's degree if you are interested in pursuing that path in order to be eligible to pass the CPA exam. And we do have strong pass rates on that important exam. And as a reminder, our accounting program has received separate AACSB accreditation. Analytics and Enterprise Systems. Remember our Edward Jones Analytics Lab. The key to our Analytics and Enterprise Systems degree is taking advantage of the fact that data is everywhere, but needing to know how to use it and how to turn that data into actual information that answers questions to better support decision-making is the key to that degree program. Economics. Economics, you have the opportunity here at SLU to pursue a Bachelor of Science in Economics through the business school, or in collaboration with our Arts and Sciences College, you can get a Bachelor of Arts in Economics. Economics is a degree program that is a strong application of analytical skills and prepares our students for success in graduate schools, private business, government service, and of course, law. Entrepreneurship. As we noted before, it is ranked number 21 by our U.S. News and World Reports. Entrepreneurship is the understanding and the ability to help with either entrepreneurial ideas, being innovative, or family businesses and startups, and how to manage a business from the ground up. Finance, a reminder again, we were ranked number 49 from U.S. News and World Reports. And we are a CFA-affiliated program. Our finance degree offers 2 concentrations, one in real estate and one in financial analysis. ITM, that would be Information Technology Management, emphasizes design, implementation, and managing of IT systems. And just a little bit of an aside, a group of our ITM students last summer went and they entered a competition that is sponsored by SAP and Deloitte to solve a real-life business problem. The competition last summer was helping a grocery store with a supply chain problem, how to best get their goods to the various locations across the country. And the competition is set up like an NCAA basketball tournament with brackets that you work your way up, and the final four in that competition was SLU, Carnegie Mellon, Texas A&M, and USC, and SLU won. And it's not the first time that we've done very well at that competition. A couple of years back, we also came in 5th in that competition. So great experience, a great way to apply the knowledge that you gain in our programs. International business. International business is a comprehensive program, and as I said before, it's rated number 13 by U.S. News and World Report. International business is, of course, understanding the challenges that come from operating globally and operating in a different part of the world. It is our only business major that requires a foreign language. Next, leadership and HR management. This program is designed to give students technical and experiential opportunities in learning about the technical and behavioral aspects of leadership and human resources, you know, the art and science of successful management. Marketing. Our marketing program is understanding customers and also is fully engaged in new forms of electronic commerce like social media and digital marketing. So our course offerings integrate traditional marketing along with new non-traditional methods and techniques. And don't forget that partnership with Nielsen gives our marketing students access to some great analytics tools and real life data. And then sports business. Sports business is an interdisciplinary program across management, marketing, economics, and data analytics. Gives you opportunities for internships with the Cardinals, the Blues, Gateway Grizzlies, along with our athletics department and more. And there are three degree programs on there, three majors that you'll notice on this slide have an asterisk. Those are degrees that are available in their entirety at SLU Madrid. So SLU Madrid is a full-blown SLU campus. It's not just a typical study abroad experience. It is really SLU, just happens to be in Madrid. The classes are in English. It's the same SLU classes with the same learning objectives. The faculty have to meet the same high standards as our faculty here on our St. Louis campus. And for those three degree programs, you could go to Madrid and you could earn and take all the major classes all the way through and earn any one of those three degrees, economics, international business, or marketing. Speaking of majors, what do you think the most popular major is for our new business students? Still deciding. So if you aren't sure what major you want to study, you are in very good company. And you have plenty of time to figure that out. In order to still graduate on time on a four-year path, you don't need to select your major until the end of your first semester junior year. Many of our students do select much earlier than that, but you have until that point, and you'll still be able to graduate on time. In addition to our 10 majors, I want to make sure that I mention that we also offer 15 minors. If you'd like to learn more about any of these programs and the specific degree requirements in more detail, or look at descriptions of some of our classes, feel free to explore on our webpage. It's catalog.slu.edu. Again, catalog.slu.edu. All right, so who wants a fabulous career once you graduate? Of course, that's true for everybody, right? Luckily, we have a dedicated career resource center just for business students right here in the Chaffetz School of Business. These are the same folks who teach that career foundations course that I talked about a little bit before, that class that's designed to help you identify your career path, learn and practice skills that will assist you in securing internships and full-time jobs, help you participate in workshops, career fairs, networking, work on your resume, etc. Also, those folks, they're a big part of why we have 85% of our students that participate in some sort of an experiential learning opportunity during their academic career. Now, experiential learning opportunities, that's internships, practicums, career-related part-time employment, study abroad, or participating in our regional business council arrangement. This is an annual program with Chaffetz Business School students and Parks College of Aviation and Engineering students, where they are matched one-on-one with a mentor and then get to participate in special events and other networking activities. By the way, 99% of our 2019 graduates were satisfactorily occupied. Now that wording probably seems a little specific, satisfactorily occupied. Notice it does not say we're working. I do want to be clear what satisfactorily occupied means. It means that our graduates who responded to our survey have indicated that they moved on to the next step that they chose to after graduating with their undergraduate degree here from the Chaffetz School of Business. Some of our students, they don't want to get a job right away. They want to go to grad school. That would be satisfactorily occupied. We have a number of students who choose to do a year of service. SLU is a Jesuit school, and we draw students who definitely feel a penchant for making a difference in the world. We have a very service-oriented student body population. And a number of our graduates each year, rather than getting a job right away, will choose to do a year of service with perhaps Teach for America, the Peace Corps, the Jesuit Volunteer Corps, the Jesuit Alumni Service Corps, go back to a Jesuit high school and teach for a year. But regardless of what that next choice was, 99% of our students landed where they wanted to, the vast majority on the first step in their career. So SLU students, and that includes Chaffetz School of Business students, tend to be a very service-oriented group. That's borne out with our number 4 ranking on this year's top 25 best schools for making an impact list, and the 2020 Princeton Review second most engaged in community service list. And in order to meet the needs of such students in the business school, we have a unique minor in service leadership. Our service leadership program is restricted, only available to business students, and it helps develop leaders who are ethical leaders and want to make a difference in the world and have a little bit of a different take to what it means to be a good leader. In order to earn the academic minor, which would actually show up on your transcript, students need to have 15 hours of additional coursework. Now, 9 of those hours are easily met with that arts and sciences core that we talked about before. It's just a matter of picking the right classes that apply to the service leadership requirements. There's also 3 one-hour leadership courses. Again, keep in mind that this is over a 4-year period. And then 12 leadership workshops, and participate in 200 hours of service. And one of the things that's really important about those 200 hours of service is that 100 of them need to be at the same site. The reason we have that requirement is that it really allows you to have that relationship and growth in understanding in the operations of that not-for-profit. So as you are spending more and more time at that one not-for-profit and understanding their needs, how they go about fulfilling their mission, you're also taking more and more business classes, getting more knowledgeable about our business curriculum, and you begin to be able to see how what you're learning in class can help that not-for-profit, and that synergy happens, and you are able to make a much bigger difference in your service site, as well as having the better understanding as you are able to see the applicability during class as you're learning your content in your business areas. Our service leaders, we find, become very valuable partners at their service sites. We've even had some of our service leaders basically become adjunct members of the board of directors of their not-for-profit as they're able to make presentations on opportunities. And personally, I'm on the board of a not-for-profit. This is the second not-for-profit that I've been affiliated with. And I can assure you that, frankly, there's never enough money to do everything that our mission calls us to do. So when students can point out ways for us to be more efficient, to make changes that allow us to have more funding, that goes right back into our community as we're able to serve our mission better. So there's a great demand in the marketplace for our service leaders. These are students who learn how to do the right thing in the right way. I'm also going to go ahead and on our next slide, I'm going to let some of our current service leaders tell you a little bit more about the program from their perspective.
I think a lot of people just think business is about making the most profit and making the most money, which is an aspect of it, but it's also really trying to capitalize on what you have and how you can help other people. The Jesuit mission of SLU and having like service be a main aspect of it kind of seems like a different take than other schools.
this service leadership program is a minor because it encompasses a lot of aspects of its actual like topic, right? You're just training to become a better leader. And that's what we need in the world, honestly. Leaders that think of those ethical values, not just the money. We're learning how to take that service leadership to the real world. We have like a 200-hour requirement of service for your 4 years here. I try to do much of my work in tutoring, music.
You're doing service with our service leadership people. Also, you can work with friends. And so it's not that hard to get 200 hours.
Another aspect is workshops, classes that you take.
A lot of classes will talk about breaking out of just focusing on your goals in your life and taking a look at what other people are doing and how we can work together.
Our teacher, he asked a question, was like, what is the purpose of a business? No, it's not just maximizing profit. It's like sustainability, solving issues within your community. And so that allows you to adopt a wider perspective of things.
People who are gonna work in business field, it's important to learn about, we need equality and equity in this world, and people are living together.
When we're taught in the business school is culture beats strategy 100% of the time. The servant leader is not your usual top-down approach. It just creates a different culture in your company.
It can help our career in the future, learning to be a compassionate and caring person, a servant leader when we get a job.
When you take into account ethical values, you're just becoming a better leader.
It's not just like I'm helping them, I'm growing throughout my service.
Helping other people, but you're also helping yourself, and you're being the best you that you can be. The core of any like good business is providing service to people, and to like be able to know how to do that, you also have to know how to serve people.
So SLU is entering our third century, and our graduates are well represented in boardrooms across the region. And like our business billikens today, they want to make a difference. They want to give back. And therefore, we find that we have an outpouring of support from our alumni who want to help students get involved. They offer career-related opportunities. They bring real-life experiences into the classroom. I am a faculty advisor for a student organization, and I have to tell you that I have more volunteers for guest speakers than I have the ability to either integrate into my class or to offer opportunities to speak at club meetings. And one of the ways that we also have our alumni getting involved is with our SLU Visors. It's a global network. It's kind of like a match.com where current students, if they would like to get in touch with recent graduates and alumni around the world, they are able to do so. And they can have the depth of a relationship at whatever level they feel is important to them. If you just would like to reach out to an alumni for a question about, hey, I have two job offers in New York. I'm looking for apartments in these two neighborhoods. Anybody have any feedback for me? They'd be able to help you with that. But if you would like a true mentoring relationship, someone to give you advice for a much longer period of time, we have SLU Visors who are absolutely happy to do that as well. And as I said, it is a global network. Yes, we have a strong support here in our region, but we have supporters around the world. Another important part of experiential learning is study abroad. And we did certainly talk already a little bit about SLU Madrid. But beyond SLU Madrid, we have relationships with about 60 programs around the world. And we have classes that we already know. If you take this class, it's the equivalent and covers your requirement of X within our program. So we can make it real easy for you to be able to go and have some sort of a study abroad experience. And that study abroad experience can be anything from an intense 1 week long program over spring break. It could be a semester. It could be a summer. It could be, as we said, with SLU Madrid, you could go, and if you're studying one of those three degree programs, economics, international business, or marketing, you could go and never come back. We want to make sure that you have the right four-year program that meets your needs. I would like to revisit that idea of my colleagues that SLU students are smart with heart. We've talked a bit today about appealing to the smart side of you and the academic rigor and the details of our curriculum. And we've introduced some appetite for that heart part in discussing the requirements of our service leadership minor. But we want to make sure that we provide plenty of opportunities for you to do good and make the world a better place. We want to make sure that you maintain balance and that you are healthy in mind, body, and spirit. So in addition to the over 200 student organizations at SLU overall, we have student groups within the Chaffetz School of Business that appeal to your interests of the business sort, that allow you to grow in your leadership skills. Honor societies, Alpha Kappa Epsilon, Beta Gamma Sigma, Beta Alpha Psi, groups that recognize your academic achievements, business professional fraternities, AK Psi, Delta Sigma Pi. These groups are a little bit of a hybrid between a business organization and maybe some of our more social Greek organizations, where we have strong networking and business topics. And of course, discipline-specific clubs, supply chain club, economics club, entrepreneurship club, marketing club, international business, et cetera, et cetera. All of these organizations give you this opportunity to be engaged and have leadership opportunities here in the business school. But I would be remiss if I didn't also bring to your attention a special opportunity for our first-year students, which is our Ethical Leaders in Business Learning Community. This is a chance for first-year business students, 83 of you, to live in community, all on the same floor in one of our new dorm buildings. And not only will you be living and having roommates who you know are similarly minded and interested in business, but you will take some classes together. And there are a couple of classes where the sections are aligned. So you would be taking a philosophy class that aligns with your business foundations class. And the instructors of those two classes work together to share some homework assignments. So perhaps you'll have a particular business problem and you'll learn about perhaps how to look at that from a business perspective on what are the considerations that need to be thought about. And then the philosophy professor will have that same problem and give you some ways of looking at that from a more traditional philosophical sense. So our students really make relationships in those learning communities, and we're very happy to offer that. But if you're interested, I'd say sign up early because it does tend to fill up quickly. Anyway, these are just some of the ways we want to make sure that you're comfortable here at SLU as the right place for your college journey. I hope our time today has given you some things to think about in regards to whether or not becoming a business billiken might be the right path for you. I know that wherever your path leads you, you'll discern the right place. I certainly hope that it is SLU. This is the point in our presentation that normally I would ask you if you have any questions. And since we're not in person, I want to offer you my email address so that you can reach out to me if there's anything that I didn't answer for you. And please reach out to your admissions folks. We're all here to help you discern the right place for you, and we hope that place is SLU. Thanks, and have a great day.